What's up, guys? Welcome back to part two of the rebuild of the Detroit Tigers on MLB Show 2017. Oops! I meant to say MLB The Show 17. In this episode, in this part, we're going to actually go ahead and play an actual game just because look at that matchup on the left-hand side of the screen. Michael Fulmer versus JV for the Mets. If you guys remember from the last episode, we ended up trading JV over to the Mets for a young prospect, one of the top prospects in the Mets organization, Gavin Cecchini. Hopefully I said that name right. I'm part Italian, but you wouldn't know it because I don't know how to say some of those names. So anyway, first things first, before we get into the game, I want to show you guys the lineup and how each guy's progressing and how they're performing in spring training. Manuel Margot, you know, we're cutting him some slack here. The 226 batting average, not so good, but you know what? It's just spring training. It's gonna be all right. He's gonna be the starting center fielder no matter what. So we gotta give him some playing time. Top 50 guy, he's a go. Bregman is struggling. Maybe we might end up sliding him down in the order a little bit. Or just give him a day off and let somebody else start at third. Just kind of so we know what we got going into the regular season if Bregman is just not there yet. So look who's hot. Randall Grichuk, 4 home runs and 8 ribbies with a 424. So our boy is doing really well here in the number 3 slot. Louis Valbuena, you know, I mean, that's kind of what we're expecting from him, right? Low batting average, can give you some power, RBIs, some walks, but look, okay. Cozart, not doing a whole lot himself. Look at Profar, 304, 3 bombs and 6 ribbies. So he's having a good spring. Michael McHenry, pretty good spring, 292 with 24 at-bats. So that's not bad either. 32 at bats for Rutledge, 125 batting average, not so good there. Michael Taylor having a pretty good spring, 265, 34 at bats. We might end up starting Billy Butler in this game against JV, just because I know it's righty on righty. Valbuena has a little bit more power. You know what? We might just go. Let's go Valbuena. Let's give him one more shot to prove himself. Lefty on righty. His right-handed power is at 72, so right-hand contact's at 61, so we might as well just go with him. Billy Butler is worse against righties, so we will go with that. James McCann, not doing so hot. Avila, 6 at-bats, no hits. Brendan Ryan, pretty good, not getting a lot of at-bats, though, so that's kind of skewed. Romine might be our third baseman for this game here. Eric Young not doing too bad himself. Presley, we're not anticipating Presley making the team, so it's okay. It's okay, bud. Maybe next year. Infante, not bad, not bad. Ref Snyder needs some work. Robinson, Cecchini. Cecchini, pretty good. 2 ribbies, 9 at-bats. Nice. We might end up getting Cecchini the start at short as well. Mikey Matuk, not bad, but he's only got 5 at-bats. So it's all limited sample size, right? But let's go to our pitching rotation. Joe Ross doesn't have any wins to really show for his effort, but he's having a good spring. Fulmer, you know, it is what it is. Danny Norris, great spring. Great spring right now. Pfister, solid spring. De Leon, great spring. Bullpen, you guys can probably see the ERAs are just not that good. But that's kind of what we're expecting anyway, right? Young pitching staff, young bullpen, puke. Cannot access the scouting part yet. It's only available in the regular season. Contracts, we will go to the coaches and scouts. We'll assign those guys after the game, so you guys will actually have something to look forward to after the end of the game. All right, so I will end up cutting out parts that are either slow or not very active so that this video is not as long as a regular game for MLB The Show is. What are those? I shoot straight, my words elemental. Those are the ugliest things I've ever seen. We're gonna wear those. I don't know why anybody would do that, but that's what we're doing. Bregman, you are sitting for row 9, and we're gonna give Rutledge the day off. We're gonna give Ref Snyder the start, and then we'll go with Valbuena. Cozart, we're gonna drop you down for Cecchini. And let's change this up. Where did Margot go? He's fine. We'll give Michael Taylor the start. So. Alright, so we want Profar leading off. That's what we want here. Okay. We want Valbuena 2. We want Grichuk 3. Man, no power in this lineup at all. Let's go Grichuk 4, Valbuena 3, let's swap it, and then we'll go yeah, that's fine. That'll be fine. It'll be all good. So just like what it said before, but I will be editing some parts out so that it's not as long. And I'm also just going to skip. I'm going to be skipping the cutscenes. All right. Let's do this. Let's go up against our former mate.
Here's Jurickson Profar, and we are ready for some.
I kind of wish Detroit would go back to. I just like the stripes. Those are kind of cool.
Jurickson Profar. And we are underway as the first pitch of the afternoon is taken for.
Fastball low. I'm going to look for that fastball.
The wind up, man.
High. I think he's going to give it to us high. No, nope. Yeah, a little circle.
The bottom of the zone for a
strike. Wonder why he would do that.
Game time temperature pushing up close to 90 degrees, 89 degrees to be exact at first pitch.
There you go, Profar. There you go. Round it hard. Get back.
For the Tigers, their leadoff.
There we go.
And he's able to get back in there at first.
Take him the other way.
Gavin Cecchini.
Profar is sneaky. We might have found something in Mr. Jurickson. The matchup of the day. Two guys that got traded for each other.
Stepping in now, Gavin Cecchini.
No, I didn't. I hate that.
That's a well-placed fastball right there. Just off the outside. If you can,
you didn't really even press X, but he swings anyway.
Have a lot of success. No luck.
Nope. See, he did it again. Dang it. Dang it. And things are not. Just got a little nerves. That's all. A little nerves. We're all right. We're good.
Really love.
Got to protect.
Threes and jamming hitters. How about that? Talk about that jam right there. That's about as good as it gets.
It's all right. Do your job, kid. Do your job.
Here's Randall Grichuk. Great chance to drive in a run here in the early going.
You guys can see the difficulties on rookie right now because I did not play
fastball that just misses ball one.
The intro that took forever. So the game downloads and then it has to install, but you can still play like the tutorial of the Cubs and the Indians. And I just never.
A change up that catches the corner for strike one.
It took 5 hours for it to install.
Behind the plate is Freddie Ferguson.
I left the game running, right?
He does reward a pitch.
I wake up the next morning and they're in the 10th inning, tied 4-4.
This is it.
Go ball.
Toward left center. Granderson on the move. And that's the second out of the inning.
That camera's deceiving. It makes it seem like he got all of it.
With two away now.
But
here's Luis Valbuena.
Yeah, I just, I don't know. I think it was a waste of space. I mean, yeah, it gives you something to do, but when it's taken 4 hours to download.
Pitch on its way from Verlander. And he lays off there 1-0.
Come on, Luis.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
I don't know, but yeah, so what I meant to say was on that is that the level, the difficulty level for the hitting, I didn't spend enough time on the tutorial for to change.
3-0 now.
JV's kind of easy to read in this game. For whatever reason, you can really see the ball come out of his hand pretty easily.
Here's the 3-0. Takes a fastball on the inside corner.
It'll be interesting.
Pretty straightforward.
Aggressively again here with the base open. He does.
All right, should I swing? Should I swing no matter where it's at? Yes, sir. Come on. Come on, Profar. Score, baby.
Third and is digging for the plate. And the run will score.
Oh, yeah.
Nothing lead.
Well, Matt, they're getting to him early.
Louis. Or Luis. Yeah.
Take it.
Bing.
No, once Roma, he settles,
get some.
He's going to dominate the game.
All right, start of the day.
Into the
Andrew Romine.
Andrew Romine.
Oh, that was juicy.
He takes a look at
that was absolutely juicy.
Things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single. Comes set and the 0-1.
Oh, that was juicy too, just late.
He's clearly looking to hit off.
JV, if you strike me out, I will never forgive you. Don't you dare do it. Oh. Did you guys see that curve? That kind of moved like a cutter for whatever reason.
Ready to deliver the 1-2.
Oh, God. Dang it. It's all right. We got one. We got one. Good start. This is actually an interesting storyline because Michael Fulmer, as most baseball fans would know, came from the Mets to the Tigers in a trade. Oh. So it's actually pretty funny that we extended the Mets and Tigers relationship. You give us your prospect, and then in the YouTube series on the rebuild, we're going to give you our old veteran ace. It's all fair. Now we're pitching against a Tiger favorite.
Yeah, she'll take a look at a slider here that finds
Curtis Granderson. He was my favorite player. Had a couple good seasons with the Tigers. Was an integral part of the World Series team.
Swing and a miss there from Granderson, and he's quickly down here 0-2.
Not World Series winners, but yeah.
Working for the punch out and the offering. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball.
But, you Cardinals fans, you just had to take it from us.
Yoenis Cespedes. First chance for him here with a runner.
Cespedes.
There's a swing.
Oh, I knew that. How do you hit a... Man, dude.
Ranging.
You hit a slider out on the outside part of the plate out for a home run.
It's a two-run shot here for Yoenis Cespedes. And the Mets move out to a 2-1 lead.
Ouch. I want to see where that was. I did miss on the location, so I wonder if that was right.
He's so strong.
I wonder if it was right down the middle.
On that ball. He just really...
You want to show another replay? No.
When it comes down to it.
Okay. Well, whatever. Let's get Duda.
Lucas Duda now.
Man, that's okay. So the slider is catching.
Man, he's flirting with danger.
That middle, yeah.
On that very same
that middle part of the plate, too much.
Right back with it in another dangerous location. He better be careful.
And he pumps the fastball by him at 94. It's 0-2.
That's how he got in trouble the last time.
Swing and a miss.
There we go.
Ran that two-seamer right by him. Second out.
It's never easy to rebound after serving up a two-run shot, but that at bat was a good indication to me that he isn't letting it.
You know, the Mets this year are going to have a pretty formidable lineup. Like, the only thing I'm concerned about for them is that they have a lot of guys that can hit a home run, but their batting average is just not,
and that pitch catches the,
it's not there. So
pretty adamant about working him,
the runs right will now come in bunches, or it's going to come in rare form.
He couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane to the plate.
It's going to be a rarity. But that's a good combination to have. You know, it's high risk, high reward for hitting, but when you have a solid pitching staff like they do,
got him swinging, and that will end the inning.
That is going to hold the opponent to low runs. So it's like a perfect combination.
Now, Michael McHenry is lined against Justin Verlander, one for six.
Michael McHenry.
And there's a fastball from Verlander to jump ahead.
All right, it's a good idea. We haven't seen him in a while, you know. Principles in real-life baseball translate to playing the show. It's like, I don't, it's like almost seamless. See what I did there? Seamless. Like, on the baseball.
Well, that was a good changeup right there. You see how he swung through that ball? Man, he's got him thinking now, because
I hadn't, we were up there batting for a little while, and then we were up there pitching for a little while. And I hadn't seen JV throw, so, I mean, just take the first pitch. If you see a strike, then you kind of get reacclimated with it.
Hit hard on the ground to second.
McHenry!
Start the inning off with a base hit. So a base hit to kick things off here, and there's a man aboard to start out their half of the second.
And JV's kind of getting knocked around a little bit.
Former College World Series MVP Rob Refsnyder is next. Here's the first pitch to him.
I bet you guys didn't know that.
A runner at first with no outs here.
College baseball MVP. World Series MVP. Dang it.
Swing and a miss right behind the big fastball.
It can be tough to lay off a high fastball like that because right at your eye level, it looks like it's so easy to hit, and then it's by you.
I'm kind of pulling for Refsnyder in this series to try to win that second base job. So I'm really putting a lot of pressure on myself to try to get this hit.
To come back with it three times in a row.
Oh, and Verlander loses the handle here. This one's straight to the backstop.
And that's, I think they're going to have to come out with a patch for that, because the spring training games that I have played, there's been a lot of wild pitches and a lot of pass balls. I know they're trying to implement
set to deal on 2-2
reality, but
got it, and he'll take this to the bag himself.
I don't know, I think that's
productive one as the runner moves up.
It almost happens too much to be realistic.
Center fielder number 3, Michael.
Meanwhile, Refsnyder did the job, move the runner over to third, get one out. Taylor can get a fly ball
90 feet away at third,
but not like that. Michael, come on, buddy, you gotta get a fly ball right here, tie the game.
And this
nope.
One
go, 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 get down, get down, get down, get down. Woo!
As the run scores. And would you believe the tying run comes into score on a wild pitch? Man, oh man.
Wonder who's behind the plate for them. It might be, is it Darno? JV with another wild pitch. See, this is what I'm talking about.
Slap hard the opposite way. Bruce is right there as he takes it for the second out.
He got that one pretty good. It just didn't have the right launch angle to carry over the outfielder's head. Small difference where the ball hit the bat could have made.
Oh, Jay Bruce almost lost it. Oh no. Might as well just give yourself up, Fulmer. It's not gonna work.
Yes, he'll take a look at ball one.
JV, throw a strike.
With two men out.
It's the pitcher.
Here's a swing and a miss, 1-1.
1-1.
I want to know why the plate coverage indicator doesn't move.
Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Fastball right back to the mound.
And he'll flip it onto like first. On that last swing and a miss, I moved it to the up and the left, and it didn't. I did it well before the pitch came in, or I pressed X. So I don't know what's up with that.
He'll start it out against Michael Fulmer to begin the inning.
We'll have to look at that in the options.
Low for ball one.
Ball one, no strike.
Fouled back. From the
really trying to get that slider going.
Chop fouled over.
Yes, it's just catching the. It's just catching too much of the middle.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out. So the base is empty.
Jay Bruce having a good spring.
And stepping in the dangerous left-handed hitter.
See, this is what I'm talking about. Like, look at the guys on this Mets team. Travis Darnot, low average, good power. Jay Bruce, low average, good power. Lucas Duda, pretty much the same player as Jay Bruce. Low average, good power. Asdrubal Cabrera, shortstop. Okay average, good power. Neil Walker, good average. Good power. So I mean, all these guys can knock it out. Cespedes.
That's lifted the other way out to left. Grichuk.
Who am I missing? Jose Reyes. I haven't seen him in the game yet.
Here's the third baseman, David Wright.
David Wright, if he gets healthy, is kind of the same situation.
And the 34-year-old veteran looks at a called strike. It's 0-1.
I kind of feel for David Wright, though. He's been having a lot of bad first inning. He's got that spinal stenosis.
Pitcher here in the second, really starting to settle.
It's just not.
Really starting to throw strikes.
It's hard.
He has been aggressive in this inning. 0-2 on
the. Oh, dude! Come on.
Recorded quick because he came right after the hitter. I don't think that changes right now either. He's going to continue to be aggressive.
He's going to ground out.
Hitter as well.
We'll get him to ground out.
Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over.
Sit down, boy. I can't wait till the experience level goes up, because the pitching is a little easy right now. Just throw fastballs down for strikes.
And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike.
Well, he got a high strike on a fastball right there. That's pretty unusual. Usually early in the count, you're going to see a guy work down in the zone. That high fastball usually the put-away pitch for two strikes. He pitched him backwards right here.
Well, that was right there, man.
Right there. Not surprised. That was after that fastball. Nice job of pitching. Kind of keeping him off balance.
So it makes JV tough. Starts getting you to foul ball. You're already down 0-2.
Verlander ready with another 0-2.
Yeah, I went.
And he starts to go.
Whoa, I didn't go?
He pulled up in time. Yes, indeed, says the third base umpire. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes.
Good job, Profar.
And this is going to find the crowd down the left.
Thing I like about Profar is that he does, he's got those quick hands.
He'll try again.
So pitches that you're not sure about.
Short. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Pitches you're not sure about till the very last second. You can foul him off.
Getting it back in quickly.
The batter, number 10.
Might be a good number two hitter.
Gavin Cecchini, 0-1 for him here.
Or he could be our leadoff guy. Who knows?
Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch.
That's
takes a look at a slider that catches the inside corner.
We're not doing anything, Dave Clark. Come on. I still haven't mastered. Oh, I saw the slider last
swing and miss.
As a hitter, you know the pitch is trying to work you down around the knees in a double play situation. So making him get a pitch up and actually in the zone is a must.
Tried to get him to go after one below the knees, but it's
I'm digging the shoes, Gavin.
Has a look, now the pitch. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2.
He's nibbling. JV's nibbling. He's like, I don't have to throw you a strike if I don't have to. If you're just going to swing at junk, which I was, now he's got to come at me.
Pitch on its way.
There you go.
Right side. And that's in there.
Dig. Dig, Profar. Dig. Oh, good throw. Hey, we got to challenge it. We got to challenge him. Keep him on their toes.
90 feet on the hit to right, but they were thinking first to third all the way.
But that's a good approach by Cecchini. We like that.
Not a real tough throw, but it was a good one.
In now, Rendell Gritcher, as he'll watch a first pitch curveball drop in there for strike one. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. The 0-1 delivery.
Oh, go ball. Gritchick did it again. Five bombs. Oh, he's a little Sammy Sosa going up to the sky. Nice.
It's a two-run shot to straightaway left, and it gives the Tigers a 4-2 lead.
That a boy. Yeah. 400 feet on a line drive.
I can tell you one thing. You might get away with throwing a
boom. Oh, my God, JV.
When you get one up like that in the zone right over the plate against these guys, you're going to get exactly what he got, a really bad result.
That was pretty JV.
Up next for the Tigers.
And poor Luis Valbuena.
Luis Valbuena.
As he takes nobody on. He's trying to win a job and he's got nobody on. But it's all right. You do what you do. You get on base.
That misses wide. One ball and one strike.
Oh, what?
Threw it to fall behind.
Late. How?
Halfway to 100 pitches. Here it is. Hit hard on the ground is short.
Those dribbles got me.
On to first, and there are two down.
What is that? No, don't pull something. You're right. You're good. Just shake it off. Look at Romine. 437 batting average, 437 OBP. What does that tell you? Singles only. Maybe one double in there, but every time he's been on base, he's gotten a hit.
The 0-1 pitch.
No walks.
Now a swing and he pops it foul behind the plate. And he'll lunge out of the crouch to put this one.
Weak.
Reactions there and the
weak.
Is over. The Tigers do
strong. Oh, should we throw at him? Should we throw at him?
Get us going in the home half of inning number three.
Justin Verlander.
Now a fastball is swung on and tipped.
Here's what we should do. We should freak him out. Slider high and in.
The windup and the 0-1. Swing.
Oh my gosh.
And this inning.
What?
With a solid base hit.
Well, that's how the game plays sometimes if you help yourself out. He's not throwing real well right now.
Wow. I know Verlander works on his hitting.
Stay longer in the game, maybe get together on the mound as well.
But what was that?
Neil Walker will stand in for the second time now as he looks at a called strike.
Guys, I'm not sure I like Fulmer's slider.
Here it comes.
Not like Joe Ross's slider. Just wait. Just wait till we get some Joe Ross gameplay going in here. You guys will like. I mean, that thing is dirty.
That fastball straightens him up a bit. 1-2 now. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive.
Come on.
Here's another 1-2. And a swing and a miss as he picks up yet another strikeout. Six of them already. And there's
six strikeouts. Like, I mean. Third inning, six Ks.
Granderson, he was a strikeout victim in his first try. Set, here it comes.
That's either the Mets or that's this game, and I honestly don't know which one it is yet. I think it's the difficulty level.
Set to deliver the 0-1.
Because some of these pitches I should not be getting away with. Come on, Gritchick. Come on, Gritchick. Get there.
Long run, but he tracks this one down out there for the second out. Nice play. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying.
Gritchick, we don't care what happens in the next 15 games, you've officially earned your spot.
He hit that two-run homer his first time up.
Get there.
On to second for the force.
Jeez, Romine.
Mets lead one.
Oh, that's, sorry, it's not Romine, it's Cecchini. What are you doing, Rook?
Digging in for his second at bat, Michael McHenry. He'll try to get it going here to begin
Michael
the fourth.
McHenry.
You guys really think Verlander would be throwing 53 pitches in like the 11th game of spring training?
It'll be interesting to see if he can settle in at all and make some adjustments, or if this start will continue.
I don't.
Granderson is under it, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Now batting, second baseman.
So digging in now, Rob Refsnyder. He's 0-for-1 thus far. First pitch on its way from Verlander. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
Ooh, nice. Ah, man, this, I like that camera angle. It makes it seem like you got a hold of it, and then it's just dead. It's like, nope, you didn't get enough of it.
Now batting, Michael Taylor comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. And here's a ball hit in the air. But no chance to run it down. It's a foul ball. Here comes the 0-1.
Nah, just late.
Off, and he's quickly behind 0-2.
I'm looking for those off speed. And then by the time I recognize it's fastball, it's just
wind up,
it's too late. It's foul ball.
Got it.
Like that. Thought that was going
to
break in.
End the inning.
It stayed in. Didn't break. All right. We got to get somebody warm. All right. Who doesn't have any innings pitched? That's who we want in this game. Do we know how many innings pitched yet? No, we don't. All right, let's get let's who we got up here. We'll get Rondon going for Travis d'Arnaud. Rondon, how are you possibly throwing the baseball looking the other way? There you go. There you go. Okay. Now that we know that you're not disabled. Okay. We're good. Let's get some Blaine Hardy action going.
Into the windup and the pitch. There's a changeup over the outside corner.
Matt, I tell you what, I love how he's pitching right now. He
has the shift going.
That first pitch for strikes.
When you hopefully it pulls on this two seam.
For great success.
Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. Some action.
You know, you want to pull on this. We want to pull you. We want to pull the grounder.
Right-hander up the throw. Lays off.
Just gonna keep giving it to you.
1-2. Here he comes on a
pull that grounder.
Hit sharp.
Right into the shift.
And he's retired.
Some people think that the shift is kind of cheap, but I don't have a problem with it. If your tendency is literally to pull every single thing,
here comes the first pitch.
Then why not flip the field? Why not flip the defensive position?
Well, he really in the first inning. Say struggle is kind.
And sooner or later,
first, but man, he's made a nice adjustment now, and is really.
You might have teams doing it on the other side of the field for right-handed hitters, who constantly pull.
Again, the pitch. You can tell he
won. Oh, that was bad as dribble. That was bad.
Side pitch anyway, and he becomes out number.
So who's a right-handed hitter that constantly pulls everything? Like Chris Carter. Chris Carter pulls everything.
His last time up, and he lays off a pitch here that he probably shouldn't have. 0-1.
I really love the way he's attacking hitters on that first pitch. It's over 80% first pitch strikes in this game. That's why.
I know he wanted to get Rondon in for d'Arnaud, but this is just too much fun.
And 0-2, so a little bit and try to put
it's time to get
you just gotta be in battle mode.
Rondon in. You're done, Fulmer. Had a good outing.
But he's already given up a couple runs this game, so maybe this is the start of something big.
Hey, ooh.
Actually, we need Blaine Hardy in. Makes his way toward the mound. Lefty on lefty. In his sixth ball game of the spring. Blaine Hardy. Here's Jay Brewston. Lift that curve. Oh my.
In the dirt here, and a nice job keeping it close. It's ball one.
This is dangerous.
The 1-0 pitch. Pulled high in the air out to right field.
You heard it here. I had reservations on that pitch.
And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Mets strand one. Still down by a count of 4-2.
All right, we will. Oh, what? Syndergaard? Yeah, we're not doing. Okay.
Digging in.
Syndergaard.
Game for him here in the fifth, as he was a late entrant into this one.
Should we do it? Eric Young versus Syndergaard? No. Here we go. Ryan.
We'll get the call.
Statistically bad at hitting against one of the top three pitchers in all baseball.
Swing and
yeah, I can't even catch up.
Well, as demonstrated there, that's a tough pitch to do anything with.
Oh, you think? If you've got a good fastball like he does, that location
is really effective.
It looks so tempting to the hitter, but making contact on that pitch can be very tough.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch.
Hey, good on our kid. Let's go now, Brendan Ryan. Never trust anyone with two first names.
Many reasons why he wasn't a very good hitter. This thing was inside and...
Oh, God. No. No, Brendan Ryan, you...
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Brendan Ryan goes down for the first out.
Why do I blame it on them? I'm the one swinging.
Jurickson Profar is in for the third time now as he takes a call.
Oh wait, that's right, because we're trying to make this like it's an actual thing. The wind up, it's real. The 0-1. It's no.
Well, finds himself.
If I was batting, I'd turn right around and ask that umpire.
Both on the inside half, both for strike.
If he knows Stevie Wonder.
Ooh,
could I?
Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2. Set to deal on a ball.
Come on, Profar. Get on base.
And he's
as
well. So make it back to back.
All right.
Here to the first two men he faces.
It's all right. It's okay.
Ready once again. Gavin Cecchini. First two men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out. So we'll see if he can.
Man, Syndergaard's, he's painting right now.
The outside corner as he'll take a look at strike one.
That's the problem when you're hitting. Even in real life, when the guy's just painting, it makes you swing at everything or feel like you have to because...
Really tough to make contact with.
Yeah, I mean, see, you're trying to... It's tough.
Bruce Rondon will come on now and take the ball for the fourth time.
So, you guys think that Bruce Rondon looks like Bartolo Colon?
David Wright, he's 0-1.
Like, do you think he'll end up turning into him? I do. I mean, look at him. Looks like Bartolo Colon.
Takes a knee.
Good pitch right there from the reliever. Tough for hitters to do much with pitches in that.
Throw that tight little slider. Oh, David. Give it to him again.
As they get a header right now.
What do you guys think? Give it to him again? I think so. I think we're going high and out. Yeah.
One away.
Sit down, number five. Let's challenge Juan Lagares.
And he just gets a
piece. Keep challenging him. Just keep challenging him.
Score here as we play inning number five.
Just right down the middle.
And this one's tapped.
Can't catch up. And then we're going to hit him with that changeup. Down in the dirt.
Swung on in the dirt, strike three. Up with it, McHenry. And
the art of pitching, boys. The art of pitching.
Tired, two down now.
Not batting.
Just kidding. It's only on rookie, you know? Rookie plus. Whatever that means.
With the first pitch, here it comes.
Strike.
Oh man,
he's got fastball going.
Out the side on
bam.
Seven down.
Just pumping it. pumping it right by him. It's change up. Change up, yeah. Let's go change up out. Change up out and low. Oh, what do you know? Man, Bruce Rondon. He's vying for that closer job at the end of 2017. Since we're trading K-Rod.
Takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Just kidding, I don't know if we're going to do that yet or not. Here's Randall Bridget. He'll do battle. We'll just have to wait and see, right? Half of the sixth. On what we're going to do. But it is time to get some Shane Robinson in for left field.
Grab a bat and lead things off here in the top of the sixth. Robinson. And he'll take strike one of the baseball, registering at 93 that time.
It's all good.
The windup and the 0-1. And a fastball just below the knee.
See, the longer you play this game, the more you start getting used to reading pitches.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch.
On what strikes and what's not. I was playing a couple games in this spring training. And
here's Luis Valbuena now. One for two on his line so far in the game.
It's just it's a lot harder to just get back into it.
Good swing, just got
it. When you haven't played in a while. You're sitting there playing all these shooters and then, you know, kind of ignoring MLB 16 the show.
Here comes the 0-1.
And then to try to jump back into this.
Throw in time at
you're just swinging at everything.
Ready for another chance.
And all right, Romine.
For two on his line thus far. Lifted the other way to left center.
Not enough.
It is Granderson. And that's the third out. Down in order go the Tiger. Shane Robinson will stay in the ballgame now and take over in left field.
Let's get Shreve in. You guys know in the last video I was talking about how I like chasing Shreve. Well,
they want to stay as patient.
This is why.
Strikes, they might want to start swinging.
Not that. But just look at that arm angle.
Now a swing and a chopper foul right at
home. Really long. The ball kind of jumps out at you. 93 with a lefty.
Popped up. Ref Snyder is there for it.
So you just watch him. You watch him when it comes to this season for the Yankees. He'll be pretty good out of the bullpen.
Home run earlier. This is in the air to left. Robinson moves over. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
The first baseman number.
Here's Lucas Duda.
I kind of find it funny that these teams or the CPU doesn't just automatically know. Hey, it's spring training and my starters. Oh my God! Do not leave it up there, please.
There's some pop on that on deck circle.
The starters are still in the game in the sixth inning. Come on, game.
Ground ball right side.
Oh, Shreve, you got to get there.
A flip to the pitcher covering as that will retire the side.
Nicely done. Nicely done, guys. This team is a winner. We've put together a winning team.
Is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven. Looks like a left-hand.
All right, McHenry. We're gonna push the Alex Avila thing. We're really trying to get him going.
First pitch of the inning is taken down.
That first year that he came up with the Tigers, I was impressed. I was like, oh my God, we finally got a catcher that can hit. And then after that, it was, where did it go?
One and two, really deceptive.
Personally, I think it's because of all the injuries that he had.
It looks like it just sort of dies when it gets close to the plate.
Probably ones that weren't even reported.
Granderson is under it. One out.
I mean, for Tigers fans who watched a lot of the games over the course of his career, he was just constantly getting just beat up catching.
And he gets him to lift one high in the air and drifting out to shallow center. And there to bring it in is Cabrera for out number two.
We're kind of giving at-bats away because
fielder number three,
well, that's a bad excuse. Try to cut down on the view time. No, if you guys are interested in this, which you all should be, because it's fun. It's fun to take a crappy team and turn them into winners. Because, hey, if you can win with a crappy team, a low payroll, then why would you need to spend more money? It'll be really fun when we start getting into the free agency or the trading deadline and make some realistic moves.
That's a good pitch, but you have to get a little bit closer to the plate than that. That's that big sweeping slider.
Because all I did to make this team was just move those players over in the roster control screen. Oh, Michael Taylor. Yeah, I turned on that. Go, ball. Woo. Even got a trophy for that. That was righty on righty with hanging slider.
And just like that,
nicely done, Michael Taylor. 414. Thanks, man. Yeah. We're good.
You could see he just
bam.
He was cruising in the seventh.
Get up on out of here. Little bat flip at the end. That's right.
And out of here, ruining what looked like a good appearance.
How many at bats is he at? He's hitting 273. Let's bring in Alex Presley, you know? He's got something to prove. I've been counting him out, you know? And we don't want to ever count a guy out like that. Not this early.
Hard hit ball to short.
If he beats this out. Yeah, there you go. Good hustle, Alex.
Mentally in the dugout already. Now he's got to regroup and find a way to get out of this. Hard not to feel for the guy.
Here's Jurickson Profar. He's running towards.
Oh, he's even stealing?
Side. Oh. Not in time as he.
Nice job, Alex Presley. Maybe we underestimated Alex Presley.
Here's the 1-0.
He knows there's a job to win.
Might have jammed him a little there.
He knows that the 25th man is up for grabs.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
Ah, Profar.
Two strikes on the hitter and two outs. I like this. You got to get this out here. You don't want them to drive in a run and you go down four. You keep it at three. You still got a chance to break it up.
Got to get through. Got to get there.
In time and the side is retired.
It's a nice play. Sorry, guys. I'm kind of having a.
Catching from here out.
There's stuff going around.
Off the benches, he'll be
and
something started in the
it's not fun. But that's not going to stop me from making videos.
He makes his second
you guys just have to deal with it when I'm hacking stuff up.
And it looks like a right-hander's got enough to throw in the Tiger bullpen. Right on the corner, a fastball that he takes for a strike.
Boyd's got to pitch well in the next couple days because De Leon looked pretty good for that number five spot.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch.
Boyd would give our rotation that second left-handed pitcher with Daniel Norris being the primary.
What he's got to do now is execute again.
And Reyes is aboard with a leadoff single. So it's a leadoff knock to start out the inning as they'll try to claw back at that three-run deficit. Wilmer Flores will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Wilmer Flores.
Especially when we're going up against teams like the Royals who like to steal.
Getting on right there, Matt. Falling so far behind, they have to capitalize. They have to get some runs to get back in this thing.
Royals who like to steal. Twins that have a lot of left-handed at-bats.
The same pitch, it looks like, in the same location. He just wasn't ready for it.
And the White Sox that are just, you know, they're up and coming. So, they're going to have
a ball and two strikes. Here it is.
They're going to be pretty much a team that's going to be pretty careless. Not careless, but I want to say the word is like reckless.
Back to him on the mound. to second for one, on to first, and that's the very last.
That's not even the right word. Just they're basically just gonna they're gonna know that they've got to work really hard to get to the playoffs, and they're just gonna leave it all out on the line. So they'll be aggressive. Aggressive is the word I'm looking for. And that'll be on the base pass, I'm assuming, as well, because Tim Anderson's fast. Yoan Moncada, he's going to be a fast. I mean, he's going to be a base stealer.
A swing and a drive to center field.
Come on, Taylor. Come on, Taylor. Come on, Taylor. Nice.
To make the play, and that'll retire the side.
That's why you're our center fielder.
Jose Reyes will stay in the ball game as a new shortstop. Eric Goodell will come on now, and he'll slide into the
lots of subs now.
Following the double switch, is into the ball game as well as he'll slide into the pitcher spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Gavin Cecchini.
So yeah, I think having two left-handers in your rotation is the best. It's probably the best policy.
Makes the play, one away.
I don't know of a lot of rotations in the majors that have three lefties.
Up next for the Tigers,
digging in for his second at bat.
I mean, there's usually about one or two. If you've got one, then I mean, it's not terrible. It's not bad. But you'd like to get two.
Out of play. Set to deliver the 0-1.
And that's just for matchup purposes.
And that'll get down in front of Granderson for a base hit.
So Boyd's pretty valuable in this evaluation process, if you will.
He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Driven nicely into the
man, we're killing it right now. Is Valbuena going to get another? Nice.
Robinson is on his way home. And a relay to the plate. And
good hustle by Robinson. Our outfielders are playing well. They're pushing it.
Expect bad things to happen. So instead of a double play ball, he gives up a shot to the outfield, and that brings the runner all the way around from first to score.
Into the box now, Andrew Romine.
They're pushing each other. At least Presley and Robinson are for that last spot.
Right side, hit hard.
Go.
Go. Down, it's through for a base hit.
Oh, go, 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 go. No, maybe not, maybe not, maybe not. No, see, that was bad. That was bad. We should have just went anyway. We knew the throw was going to be offline. It's spring training for everybody, right? Including your boy.
And a fastball runs in a bit too close for comfort that time.
Not sure if that was a purpose pitch or not, but I
like. So, as a pitcher, who you guys got in the World Series this season?
Running something hard inside.
Yeah. Yeah, I went there.
Standing in the batter's box against you.
Opening day starts on Sunday.
It's so tough to get around.
And I'm already asking about the World Series.
Pitch out. Nothing doing.
It's not these Tigers, I can tell you that right now. I'm just
on the move, and
but no, if you guys want my honest opinion, it's a hard.
Again, he sends it out of play.
Did Avila just hit a bomb? Oh man, he could have.
Runs, 9 hits and no errors in the ball game for the Tigers.
Oh, Avila. It's going to be hard for the Tigers to actually win this division. Not in this game. I'm talking about real life. It's going to actually be really difficult for them to win the division. They've still got the good players, you know. They've V-Mark, Kinsler, Verlander, Fulmer. I mean, it's all there. Upton has a good year. Iglesias has a good year. Cabrera, if he's not hurt, JD Martinez. So I mean, it's all there. The ability to win that division is all there. It's that, you know, the Indians are great.
And this one's hit on the ground, but foul.
I don't see the Royals doing much. I think that they, I mean, losing Ventura here comes with his with his death. And after a good start to the inning, they can't capitalize any further. Just the pitching in general.
Here's the third baseman, David Wright. He'll see what he can do leading off the home eight.
White Sox are just, you know, they're trying to get things going.
Ref Snyder fields.
Good play, Ref Snyder. Very nice. How much? One out, please.
Here to hit now is Matt Reynolds. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. Below the knees,
I mean, Tim Anderson's obviously young shortstop. He's gonna be making some errors. You're always gonna expect the mental mistakes. You know, it just may cost some games. He might surprise. He might actually be great. You know.
2-1.
I like Tim Anderson. I like him as a player.
He's fallen behind.
Come on.
3-1.
One thing that could nag at you as a pitcher is having to work really hard to get a guy that you think you should be able to cruise
right. Wow, Cecchini. I know that was a rocket right at you, dude, but you got to make that play. It's in the air. It's not like it's...
He'll be summoned off the bench here as he'll pinch hit with the runner at first and one gone in the inning.
And then you got the good old Twinkies who are going to be a thorn in everybody's side. You've got...
0-1 count and
Joe Mauer, the leader of the team. Young Ho Park is sneaky. Sneaky.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch.
Miguel Sano.
And this one's in the dirt. And forget about the double.
Hit some home runs. It'd be big for him. Max Kepler had a good. I mean, Max Kepler was out of nowhere. I mean, people liked him, but I don't think they thought he was going to be that good.
First, two gone.
Buxton, if he becomes the prospect, becomes the player that everybody thought he'd be. So the Twins are sneaky. It's just their pitching is not too great.
From the belt, the pitch. Breaking ball taken right down the middle.
Oh, he hung him one right there. Curveball right down the middle. Those balls go a long way. He must have been looking for something.
So it's going to be, you know, it's going to kind of be a...
seats near third.
That was a good pitch to hit.
They're going to eat each other up in the Central. Pretty much, but I think it's the Indians' division to win. The Astros are, if you guys have looked at the Astros lineup, it's pretty good. It's pretty insane. So I like the Astros in the West. AL East, obviously the Red Sox. I mean, I don't know who else you're going to pick other than if, oh my gosh, I didn't even press X.
In a real game situation here.
Really tied him up on that one.
Unless you're going to get frisky and pick the Yankees, but
I might go right back in there.
Do the Orioles get it done this year? Do the Blue Jays get it done? I don't think the Blue Jays can do it. I mean, they lost Edwin Encarnacion. Tulo is
they really bunch him up on that one as he swings in
a glass of whiskey. I mean, I don't know.
Here we'll have a pinch hitter here as Omar Infante has grabbed a bat and made it.
And I'm a Blue Jays fan. I mean, I want to see him do well, but I just don't think I don't think they have it in them this year.
Against right-hander, as this is a ball 1-0.
All right, yeah, let's get Salvador Fernandez in there.
One out, nobody on.
Close the game out. I love Infante's stance. It seems like he can just unload on a ball if he wanted to. Sorry.
Here's Jurickson Profar. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Schedule to put in the game. We'll have Matt Bush be our secondary guy if things get sticky. We'll give K-Rod the day off. But we're on our way, guys, to another victory here. We'll be 5-7, I think, on the spring. and we'll just I'll simulate some games, and then the next game that I see that's kind of an interesting matchup, we might not have another spring training game. Who knows? At least another spring training game to show.
They're going to need to string some hits together in this last.
I gave that bat away. I just, you know, got to get it done.
Fernandez.
All right, here's our boy.
Now is the new pitcher.
Number 24.
This season, 10 games. He's pitched in 10 of the 11 games. Oh my gosh, I'm working. This team's working him. He might only get to face this one batter. It's just too much.
The fastball that time is his chop foul at the plate for strike one. The wind up and the 0-1.
In fact, I think we might do that. I don't think anybody has pitched from the bullpen 10 games in spring training.
Drill down the line and a reach to his back.
You gotta at least get an out.
Up with it, and the leadoff man's aboard.
Well, no surprise, another single to lead off the inning here late in the game, but they haven't had a lot of runs. They've got a lot of hits today, but they haven't been able to put things together. I guess I give a little credit to the pitchers.
Look at that, 97.
Consecutive hits.
If you can get him, Rondon,
life of a pinch hitter, you maybe get one at bat,
and then go with K-Rod at the end with his devastating changeup. I mean, that's huge. It's gonna shorten the game.
Right side of the infield to worry about with the first baseman holding the runner on. It's always smart.
Get a little slider high and in. Oh my! Get him! Get two! No!
Goes to second, and they do get the out there. But they won't get two.
We got the out at second?
Number seven, Kevin Plawecki,
will be summoned off the bench here.
Really? I want to see that. I don't know how that happened. But yeah, let's go to Matt Bush. No. There we go.
Enters from the bullpen, hoping to get the final two outs. And
let's end this thing.
Into the win column. In the dirt here, and no advance. It's ball one. The 1-0 delivery, and he won't bite at that one either.
That missed pretty bad.
On 2-0, you can bet he's looking for a fastball that he can turn on and drive. Might be thinking about picking on that big hole between
Matt Bush with the 97.
And he'll lay the
fastball. Jeez, dude, we got some guys that can.
2-1.
Throw the heat.
Takes a look at a strike over the inside corner. Runner at first here, one man out.
We're just gonna keep dosing him with fastballs.
And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. Striding into the
ball. All right, Renee.
Renee Rivera, and he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out.
That was a good swing, so we might want to just try to miss his bat here.
And this is cut
there
out and missed, so the Mets are down to their final strike now.
So it makes a good pitcher. You got to be able to read the swings. We got a good call. Good job, boys. That's how you get the W. I don't know how Matt Bush is inside the dugout right now. He was just on the mound.
You have to feel really good about yourself. It's not easy going into that other team's ballpark and coming out with a win, but they did just that.
And let's check it out. So we had Michael Taylor with a home run. We got Grichuk with the bomb. Valbuena actually went 2-for-4 with two ribbies. He had a good day just when we were starting to question him. Fulmer with 3 2/3 with 7 strikeouts and 2 earned runs and no walks. He did give up the 2-run bomb to Cespedes. And that's pretty much, yeah. Everybody had a great game. Other than Justin Verlander. 4 innings and 4 earned. I only struck out twice. So that might have been a good trade for us. I think Cecchini had a hit in that game, I believe. But, yeah, so all in all, good game. We will simulate up until I find a good matchup that we can show off again and kind of get one more little update on some of our players and how they're doing in the position battles. I think it might have to be... It might be against the Yankees. I'm thinking. We play Atlanta a lot. Pittsburgh might be an interesting... Miami might be an interesting matchup. What's up with all the Yankees and Atlanta games? Yeah, so we're almost halfway through. We'll be about halfway through during this week. I think I might show the Atlanta game. I think that one will be fun. So, look out for that one. We're not going to know who the projected starters are. It's too far out. But, yeah. So, our guys are starting to come around as a team. Everything's looking pretty solid. Everything's looking pretty good. I did want to go through this and hire and fire some guys. So, we'll end the video like this. We want... Wow. Remember what I just said? Don't trust people with two first names. Kelly Kelly. Cool. Let's go with Gerald Jones. Kelly Kelly. You fired. Yes, we are firing you. So we've got, let's see, we've got International, Central, West, and Central. We've got two guys in Central. Obviously, discovery is huge. Efficiency. If you find a guy that you really, if you do it manually, you're not going to need anybody for the efficiency, really. So I don't really focus on efficiency because I like to do my scouting manually. I like to just pick my guys out that I like to focus on, especially because I know my roster. I know the positions that I want. So I'm not so big on this efficiency. What I do want to see is discovery. So this guy right here, Yoder. Yoder's probably the guy. Unless it's Park. You got a 93 discovery. His efficiency's pretty good, but his positional players are bad. Pitcher's at 66. We gotta go with Yoder. Yoder for our East, right? And then I think, yeah, we don't. We don't need that. We don't need Gerald Jones in the Central. We just don't. We just don't need it. But is he better than this guy? Might have to keep him. Oh, no, we don't. I mean, this guy, he's not bad. We'll keep Heath Tuttle, and we will trade him for a West guy. That's what we'll do. Or we should go International. And I'm thinking we should probably go West. Our pitchers are pretty young, but I think we need to build on the pitching staff. I think that's the way to go. Fister's getting old. Some of our bullpen guys are, you know, not super young as well. The only young guys we really have are Ross. Well, what am I talking about? We got Ross, De Leon, Norris, and Fulmer. So we do have a young pitching staff, but I think I like the trading ability, the trade bait that you have for young pitching. If we can draft good, solid pitching and put that in the minor leagues, we can easily trade those guys over for more established veteran hitters that have more control on their contracts. So that's actually not a bad idea. If you start getting in the positional players and you call them up and they start doing well, it's harder to re-sign young players because they're trying to look for the big payday, the big paycheck. So positional players are hard to find. Young pitching is easier to trade because their lifespan is a lot shorter than a positional player. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna get rid of Gerald Jones for Brandon Francisco. And there we go. So now we're rounded out. and I think that that is it. So I don't... Brad Ausmus, 1 year left. Depending on what happens, Brad, we might be letting you go. Eli Simmons, K per nine. Home run down. Well, we don't need that. We need a pitching coach like Ian Aaron. K per nines go up, home runs per nine, hits per nine. Yeah, I mean, Ian Aaron, you're our guy. Totaling $1.65 million. Yeah, yeah, we're doing it. So we want you... What are you asking for? Does it tell you where you, what you asking for? No. We'll just make that up. Aaron, yeah, that's right. That's right. Dave Clark, one, minus one, minus one. These guys aren't doing anything. We'll give them a chance, but those negatives are never, never good. So, all right, guys, that is it for this episode. I will see you guys in the next one. Like I said, we're eyeing for the Atlanta game, but if something comes up in this time, maybe against Washington, maybe it's against Washington, we get to play against Miguel. So Joe Ross actually against Miguel, so that'll be the game right there. We'll go for that game right there for episode number 3. So, and we'll scour the free agents, see if we can make the team better. We'll look at some outfield options. I know Presley impressed. Get it? Impressed. Yeah. Shane Robinson's doing a little bit of everything, but we do need to look for at least some minor league depth. So, all right. So if you guys leave a like, thank you very much. Appreciate it. And if you like it and you love it and you want more of it, give me a little subscribe. If you guys want to see more and get updates on more of it. So I will see you guys later. Thanks. And as always, peace.